So we're working on several different projects, but the main theme is employing machine learning techniques for the advancement and to improve the efficiency of the engineering design process. When you look at the things that we use in the world, ranging from the chair that you're sitting on to aircraft geometry, it follows a specific set of processes, which we call the engineering design process. And that starts with the acquisition of user needs or their preferences, and then the engineering designers come up with ideas in terms of how to solve these problems. And so what we are employing machine learning techniques to do is to make this process more efficient. Now, one of the barriers that has typically plagued virtual reality beyond the hardware is actually the software, so the content creation. And this is really where we feel as though AI has the potential to enhance human knowledge acquisition by actually creating or helping to create these virtual reality environments. And so we're really excited about this connection between AI and virtual reality and the 3D content generation, because that is really at the heart of many things that we do in society. It turns out that the same hardware that can take a video or a picture can actually be used in the healthcare domain. So if you think of what a picture is, it's really just a collection of pixels, so very small squares that have color. What's interesting is if you take a video of someone's face, it may be unobservable to the human eye, but when your heart is beating, there's a very slight color change in your skin. And it's that very subtle change that these computer vision algorithms are able to capture. And by doing so, you're then able to capture very cool things like someone's pulse rate, their respiration. So imagine as someone's going to the hospital, their vital signs are already being captured and sent to their medical team, so that by the time they get to the hospital, there's been an initial kind of characterization of what may be going on with this individual. And we're doing all this with commercial off-the-shelf devices, your cell phone. And so I really think we're really living in an exciting time in society where off-the-shelf technologies coupled with algorithms are really able to democratize the access to knowledge. And then that's really what we're interested in expanding.